what it was. Y'all know who it is, and y'all tuned in with Priceless Knowledge Itself, and I figured I'd hit y'all with a little cosmic insight for the day. And say, man, it's Monday again, so it's time that we discuss a little bit more of this karmic destiny. And if we're gonna do that, we might as well have a little fun. So this right here, this gonna be a little something about those people that have the North Node in Gemini and the South Node in Sagittarius in their natal chart. And before we even go there, what I'm gonna do first is, I'm gonna bring y'all a little information on the North Node in astrology. And then I'm gonna bring y'all a little information on the South Node in astrology. And then if you're lucky, I might give y'all a little breakdown on how us astrologers use the North and the South Node, and also give y'all a little bit of information on what they mean in the different astrologies. Because there is Draconic astrology, there's Babylonian astrology, there's Kabbalistic astrology, there's Western astrology, which is what we're doing, or tropical. There's Vedic or Sidereal. There's all kinds. There's Chinese astrology. There's so many, and they're all applicable. So you might need to do a little bit of searching, man, and a little bit of information, because this is deep. So in astrology, your life's purpose is encoded in the North and the South Node of the Moon, or referred to as Rahu and Ketu, respectively, in Vedic astrology. And they're not actual celestial bodies either, y'all, but they're rather two mathematical points in the chart that fall directly opposite one another. And they kind of create this axis of sorts in opposite signs and opposite houses. For instance, if your North Node is in Capricorn, then your South Node is in Cancer. And if your South Node is in the second house, then that would mean your North Node would be in the eighth house, and so on and so forth. But the nodes help us answer questions like, what am I supposed to do with my life? Why am I here, and what's my mission? Even, why the fuck am I like this, and what might I have been in a past life? Yeah, we're gonna talk about past life stuff, y'all. And if you don't believe in that, I respect your beliefs, but I do, and I'm asking you to respect mine. I also implore you to go do some research and really do some soul searching, because you've been here before, homie. And so let's talk a little bit about what they bring to the table. So the North Node, or Rahu, you know, this is your destiny. This is where you need to go now. And this is kind of like your karmic path in this life. And I like to think that the North Node illuminates the terrain that's calling your name. But climbers to the peak of this mountain is going to be like trying to get up to the top of Mount Everest, man. So you might have to lighten your baggage and enlist some help if you want to make it up to the top of this motherfucking hill. And, you know, this is like your learning curve in a way. Because Rahu activities, they're going to require you to break out of your box and get out of your comfort zone. You know, this is the activation of your life's mission. And the sooner that you align yourself with this path, the more purpose-driven your life will become. Pardon me. And, you know, at the same time, you're going to always return to your South Node as that kind of ace in the hole at certain times, even after you've made your way in this life. But look, when it comes to the North Node, you know, I really think that a lot of us get caught up in thinking that just because we're good at some shit, or because we've mastered something, or our skills inherently, you know, that just makes us, that might be what we're supposed to be doing with our life. But really, you're going to learn that that's probably not going to be spiritually satisfying. You know, it's not going to be nourishing to your soul, because you've done that in many lifetimes before. That's why this energy is mastered in you. That's why you have these skills. So this time, it's time to go on the opposite end of the spectrum. You know, it's time to flip the script. And that's kind of what the South Node is, or the North Node is. And so the South Node, these are your innate gifts, your inherent gifts. This is past life shit, man. This is the stuff that you brought with you into this life from wherever you came from before. And so the South Node is the exact opposite sign as the North Node. And it, like I said, it reveals the gifts that you brought with you. It's your comfort zone, or your sweet spot. And you're going to be innately good in these areas of life, which, you know, it may cause you to begin your early path based on Ketu's energy. And while this might bring you a little sense of satisfaction, it's never going to be spiritually nourishing, which is what we're about. Because with the South Node, indeed, you probably have been there and done that. It's awesome, been there and done that type shit. And that's why you got to flip the fucking script and use Ketu as a springboard into Rahu's activities, man. What I'm saying is, man, you got all this energy inherently. You're good at this. Okay, that's great. Use that to help you get good at the shit that's at the opposite end of the spectrum. You know what I mean? You have to break out of your comfort zone if you want to ascend. And that's kind of what the Ketu and Rahu are about. Pardon me, y'all. And so us astrologers,
We use the nodes to determine where your destiny lies in this life with the North Node or Rahu, and kind of what you had going on in past lives with Ketu or the South Node. And as far as their transits go, the nodes change signs about every year and a half or every 18 months. And this shit goes well beyond just Western astrology, y'all. You know, and this life too. It goes well beyond this life. In Jewish or Kabbalistic astrology, you know, they focus primarily on the nodes, and they call the North Node your tikkun, or your correction. And it views it as the karmic adjustment that you must make in this life in order to ascend. And in Vedic or sidereal astrology, you know, Rahu is the head of the dragon, but he has no tail or no body. And Ketu is the body or the tail of the beast, and he has no head. And, you know, Vedic really takes a harsher perspective on the South Node's karma. So to sum it all up for y'all, man, this shit right here is fucking crucial. It's crucial. So pay attention. Also, man, the house placement here, you know, this is even more imperative than the signs are. And we'll talk about that at a later time. But this is some real shit. So what about these people that have their North Node in Gemini? What does that mean? So right off the rip, what I'm going to say is the universe is trying to tell you people to loosen the fuck up, you know, learn how to enjoy the beauty of life while also working on your motherfucking communication skills. Yeah, these are absolutely charming, persuasive, and perhaps even very manipulative motherfuckers. And either way, they usually manage to win everybody's fucking attention with their little ways. Gemini, Rahu, and Sagittarius Ketu natives, they're forging their life's purpose out of being teachers, students, writers, or spreaders of messages this time around. You spent many lifetimes wandering about, seeking truth, and developing your spiritual philosophy. So this particular existence, you know, it's about gathering together and learning how to spread that knowledge effectively and more tactfully, especially. As a matter of fact, no matter what you do this time, or no matter how you even flip this particular axis here, it comes down to having lots of friends and meeting new people. And it's about what goes on in the exchange after that. You know what I mean? Once they're engaged, and that's pretty cool. You know, on another note though, people with their North Node here, they usually find themselves occupying very important positions. And that's because they have this universal knowledge and this previous well of existence that their soul knows and their soul remembers, even if their brain doesn't, and it wouldn't. You know what I mean? It's ingrained inside of them. And when it comes to these folks in particular, man, learning to live a more simple reality is going to be essential in understanding that the world isn't revolving around only just one individual's, you know, will and one individual's meaning. You know what I mean? And reality is actually just as complex as you make it be, man, because it really can be a lot more simple. And the same goes concerning the seriousness of this existence, man, because at the end of the day, you judge you. You judge you. And it doesn't revolve around what the fuck you want, though. You have to learn how to love. So I say that when these people were young and in previous lifetimes, you know, people with Rahu and Gemini, they most likely were real cool and very sincere, because at some point, motherfuckers probably ran them off in past lives or even offended them and insulted their intelligence, which is pretty much a cardinal sin to anybody with Sagittarius placements, man. Problem is, a lot of people are fucking intimidated by their straightforward and powerful energy that they come with. And even if they need to hear the message that the South Node in Sagittarius, North Node in Gemini person has, you know, they're taken aback by the way that they come up that, you know, is blocked. It's because they got this passion and this exaggerated energy. As a matter of fact, they're going to have to learn to serve their truth in doses if they're ever really going to have an appreciative audience in this life. And even more than that, you know, they need to learn how to articulate their words and, you know, be a little bit more skillfully and artfully instead of just blurting out whatever the fuck comes to mind, because sometimes people can't handle that. We understand that's your truth, but sometimes people just can't handle that. They just can't. They have to understand that communication goes well beyond just fucking words, man, or sounds even. It's about the subtleties. It's about the vibe. It's about vibrating effervescently. You know, it's about posture. It's about glances. It's about smiles. It's about little winks. You know what I mean? It's all about that, man. You have to know how to make people feel like they want to engage with you if you really want them to listen to you. You know what I mean? When you just come out hollering what you feel or hollering what you see, hey, people can feel your passion, but it's scary because not everybody is with that. And that kind of goes both ways. You have to respect it both ways, you know, really. And lastly, in relationships, you know, they have got to learn to be more loving and willing to communicate with their person, because they're going to keep getting stuck in these same old cycles. And it ain't that serious, man. As a matter of fact, the North Node in Gemini says that nothing is that serious. Nothing. So a little bit about having the South Node or Ketu in Sagittarius, you know, motherfuckers with Ketu here, they need to come off down their little high horse, man. Yeah, pun intended. And play with the rest of us this time. That's real. They really tend to get caught up in a little superiority complex a lot. But it's long fucking past time to let that fucking shit go. And you might see that the universe might humble your ass if you don't do it yourself. If you don't understand. Most likely in past lives, these folks were priests, philosophers, high-ranking government officials, and people of culture who traveled the world expanding their knowledge and developing their highly evolved belief systems. These are the kids that, you know, are born with uncanny ability to learn different languages and shit. And, you know, the kids who are always talking about traveling to different countries and shit like that. And it's because their soul remembers what their mind can and longs for the comfort that they find in things of a foreign nature, which is crazy. However, you know, they aren't here to experience the same shit all over again. None of us are. You know, it just doesn't go like that. Because while they were searching for that truth throughout the fucking universe, they somehow missed something in their immediate surroundings. And so, you need to pay attention to whatever the fuck is going around, you know, in your immediate environment, because there's something you're missing. There's something that you need to learn. And once you do learn it, you need to learn how to communicate it effectively and without being so motherfucking blunt. You can still be honest, but you can also be tactful. And that's really what this is about more than anything else. They have a tendency to hold on to some beliefs and points of view without actually even having all the motherfucking facts. And, you know, to toy with motherfuckers' feelings just to do it and then ghost them for no motherfucking reason, man. And then they also just move on from place to place because their energy is just so motherfucking nervous. That's what it's all about. And this lack of tact in relationships and the inherent fear that somebody is gonna just take away or restrict their freedom, that's restricting their freedom. And until they realize that, they're gonna keep running into brick walls. And so this is always going to be a constant struggle for them. And they're going to have to deal with that in this life if they're ever going to want to ascend. But with this particular axis, shit just so happens to be easier done than said this time around, ain't it? A little crazy, huh? Maybe you need to work on that. So, hey, man, it don't matter where your North Node is. It don't matter where your South Node is, man. Just because you build like that, it don't mean you have to build like that. But if your South Node is in Sagittarius, you might need to try to let yourself have a little fun this time, man. And you might need to learn how to speak to people the right way, because the way that you're coming off is not allowing your message to be received. And that's not going to help, because y'all have some of the greatest philosophies because of the experiences you've had and because of this knowledge and wisdom that you've gained, man. There's so much that you have to share. But if you don't learn how to communicate it effectively, ain't nobody going to be trying to hear that bullshit, man. So what you do with it is what you do with it. Hey, this has been some priceless knowledge itself. If y'all fucking with me, man, please like, share, subscribe, man. Hit that like button, man. Help me get on this algorithm so I can get out there and help some old people, man. I appreciate all the love and support, man. Y'all go join my Facebook group, Priceless Knowledge Itself, also, y'all. Hey, man, I'm going to keep pushing. I'm gonna keep pushing. I'm gonna keep pushing. Cause it ain't nothing to it but to do it, man. And I've just learned that so much, man. And I enjoy bringing this knowledge to y'all as much as I hope y'all enjoy receiving it, man. And so that's what's cracking. If you're interested in the astrological readings whatsoever, you can either hit me up in the comments below or email me at mr.turner1300@gmail.com. And say, man, that's in Western, Vedic, or numerology. And fuck with me, man, because if you're fooling with somebody else, you really tripping, man. You out of line, and I ain't even gonna say nothing else. But y'all keep it real till I come back in a little bit with a little something about those people that have the North Node in Cancer and the South Node in Capricorn in their natal chart. I appreciate it, cuz.